I was seeing creators and mutuals posting beautiful screen recordings of their projects or tools that they were using for months. These were perfectly animated. The mouse would move around the screen, the zooms were all perfectly timed, and I knew I needed whatever tool that they were using. It took me some time and digging, but I finally figured out what literally everybody was using: Screen Studio. Screen Studio is a screen recorder for Mac OS that makes recording your screen as easy as taking a screenshot. It levels up your presentations and your videos. We use this software basically every day to create X content, YouTube videos, site content, and more. So keep watching. I'm going to show you exactly why it's become my go-to for all things screen recording. All right, so let's go ahead and get started. I'm going to show you just a basic overview on Screen Studio, how we create these beautiful videos. So let's go ahead and jump in. So I'm just here on my desktop. Screen Studio is only available for Mac users, so keep that in mind. I'm gonna go and open Screen Studio, and then this is the interface of Screen Studio. So I have four options here, and this is everything that I can record with Screen Studio. I can record a display, I can record a window, an area, or a device. If I just pull my browser over here, you can see when I choose display, it will choose either my first monitor, and then it also gives me an option to choose my second monitor. Or if we do window, I can choose my window, so it's finding my Google Chrome. If I had any other applications open or any other windows open, it would give me the option to choose those as well. You can also go in and resize this. So if I wanted to do a square and I would just give it permission, it would record it as a square. Let me put this back. And then if I wanted to do an area, this is where you will drag to record certain areas. So this could be here. So I could record just a small part. I can move this around before I start recording. And you can also, if you need specific dimensions, you can put this in here and also custom position it as well. And then you can also record a device. So I've used this a couple times, super cool tool, really cool for social media posts, especially if you have an app that you want to share. It's a really cool way to capture the UI of your app and its functionalities. So all I would do here is click device, and then I just plug in my phone to my docking station, and then it'll show up here. So you do have to be connected by a USB. It's not Bluetooth at this moment. Let's say I wanted to record a window. I would just choose window, start recording, and then I would capture something. So I'll just put no code devs in here. Scroll around some. Look at this. Okay, and then I'll go ahead and end this recording. And once I end it, then I have my recording. So this is the editor of Screen Studio. So you can go ahead and rename this. I'll just do YouTube demo, and then it will save it like that. And then as you can see, let's just watch of what we captured. We have our recording and it's zoom. So most of the time, depending on what you're recording, your zooms aren't going to be perfect, which is totally fine because the editor in Screen Studio is super easy to navigate. So I'm just going to go ahead and remove this. This was just an auto zoom. And keep in mind that when you're recording, the zooms are triggered by where you click. So if you notice here, I clicked into my search, it started zooming, and I was continuing to click around, so the zoom captured. But for this, I'm just gonna remove that. And if I wanted to be more precise about where I was putting my zooms, I can navigate here through the timeline. So if you wanna move throughout your timeline, you need to be clicking at the top. If you click down here, you'll add zooms. So I'm gonna move down here and I'm gonna see where I initially clicked. So looks like this is where I initially clicked. I'm gonna drop a zoom right there and then it'll zoom in. And then this is just an auto zoom. However, I can do a manual zoom to get a more precise and detailed zoom. So I can also drag this to make the zoom longer. But for now, let's take a look at how I can manually do this. So if you look here on the side, I have a couple options and we'll take a look at that in just a second. But for now, let's look at how we can do this manually. So if I click into the Zoom, I get these options. You can disable the Zoom, so you can just record the screen without any zoom throughout. Or you have your zoom mode, which is auto. Zoomed in camera will automatically try to keep the mouse cursor visible. Or you could do manual. So once I click manual, you can see I can actually choose where I would like the zoom to hone in on. And then I can also choose the zoom level. So if I wanted it to just slightly emphasize there, or I can really get in there and zoom in up to 400%. And then you can also reset it. You can set a default. You can apply this manual setting to all zooms, which is really nice. And then you can obviously remove your zoom. So let's say I wanted this just to move in a little, and then I want to make sure it's right in the middle. Let's watch this back. And then we'll zoom out. Amazing. So now let's take a look at some of the different options we have here in this side. So we have our background and screen. From here, you can choose the background of the recording. You can choose from a wallpaper, a gradient, color, a specific image you can upload. Another thing really nice about Screen Studio is they have these Mac OS wallpapers, which are super cool. So I can choose from any of these. They have Spring, so different gradients. Lots of different options to choose from. You have raycasts, tons of gradients. You can customize these, so you can add your own colors if you want for branding. And then if we scroll down some, you can see we have our padding. So here is where you can adjust how big you want the background to be of your recording. So it goes all the way up to 35%. Makes it pretty small, or you can completely remove the background and it can just be your screen recording. And then you can also adjust your corners. So if you want them super rounded, up to 200, or you could have straight corners. Your inset, which is really nice. I actually use this one a lot more than I thought I would, but you can inset your screen recording. Maybe if you have something cut out or you want to emphasize something, or the hero is not necessarily going to be in the middle and you want that to be emphasized, this is where you would use your inset. And then you can also change the color of that as well. And then you can also adjust the shadow of your screen recording. So if you see there is no shadow now, I can adjust that. And I think this looks really nice. I tend to gravitate towards that one a lot. And then they also have advanced shadow settings, which you can adjust. You can choose the angle. Very nice. And then you can also add your favorites. So if you are recording a bunch of videos and you want to be consistent, you can add your favorites there. Another really cool thing is the cursor, which I really appreciate, especially in demo videos or promotion videos. I really like the look of a cursor. I think it helps the viewer follow along and just adds extra value to the video. So if we click into cursor, you can see we do have the option to completely hide the cursor, so I wouldn't have the cursor throughout the entire video. Or we can adjust our cursor size, so we can have a really small cursor or up to 8, which is pretty big. And then we can also change our cursor type. So we have our Mac OS, so let's change this. Let's go to back. Okay, so you could do your Mac OS or you could do touch, which is cool if you prefer this one. And then you can also hide the cursor if it's not moving. So if I'm doing a demo video and I take about 2-3 minutes to explain something, the cursor will go away. You can also loop the cursor position. This will be near the end of the video. The cursor will move back to its initial position. And then there's also advanced settings as well. You can rotate the cursor. You can stop cursor movement at the end of the video. You can remove cursor shakes. You can adjust the cursor shakes threshold, and then you can also optimize cursor changes. So Screen Studio will try to minimize rapid cursor changes. And then since I didn't record any camera, I will not have an option there. No mic recorded and then no audio recorded. We won't see those, but I will show you those later on in the video. I also have my keyboard shortcuts, and then we also have our animations. So we can go and animate any of our cursors or our video. You can change through cursor movement, animation style, mellow. You have slow, quick, and then rapid. You have your zoom movement animation style. So these are just little things to customize your recordings. Then if we take a look up here, We have our presets. So if you do set presets, they will be up there. You can close your editor sidebar. You can preview performance settings. And then we can also change our ratios up here. If I want vertical, if you're recording for social, you have all of these options here. And then you can also crop your recording as well. And then if we move over to this corner, you can see we have this file here. This is going to be where all of our Screen Studio projects are saved. If I click into here and if I open them, these are some of my other projects. Another thing that I'd like to note, to move through this timeline, all you have to do is use your scroll on your mouse. So to navigate through, just move up and down and that'll go out. And then another shortcut that I like to use is Command plus and Command minus to zoom in and out of your clips. And then the last thing for this is you can also split your clips. So if I click here on these scissors, I can split my clip. Another thing I like to do is choose my split. So if I move throughout this timeline, you can see I can put a pin in it. So if I want this specific area to be split, that pin will stay there. I can grab my scissors and I can split and I know exactly where to. And then you can also cut out pieces, crop them. You can remove clips. I can set my speed. So if I wanted a certain clip to be faster or the entire thing, I can make it times two. I can set the volume. And then I can also merge with next or previous clips. So that's just a quick overview on Screen Studio's interface and how you'd get started with them. I just want to show you really quick how it would look if I was recording with a camera. I can go and choose my camera here. This isn't going to have me on it since I am recording. And then I can choose my microphone. And then you can also record system audio, which is super nice. So if I wanted to record me reacting to another video, it would have Chrome for me here and I could record the sound from Google Chrome. Super nice, but I'm not going to record that for now. So let's do area. Then we'll include the recording of me in it. And then this is also where you start and stop. And then you can also reset your recording as well. So let's grab that clip. It'll open for us here. And then as you can see, when you're recording and you have a zoom, the camera still has a focus on it and you will be able to still see your recording of yourself. And then if we go into the editor, we now have these options available. So camera, I can change the position of the camera throughout the recording, which is super nice. You can mirror the camera. You can change the roundness. So if I wanted it to be a circle, you can choose the size. And then you can also choose the different size during zoom. So during a zoom, I could adjust this. So if I wanted my camera to be bigger whenever it zooms in or smaller, I don't want myself to be the focus. You can change that here. You can generate a transcript of your captions whenever you have an audio recording. And then audio, you can mute the microphone or you can improve microphone audio. That was just a quick overview on Screen Studio. It's a super awesome software. I highly recommend it. It's made me excited for content creation and just creating videos. Makes things super easy. And if you try it out, make sure you let us know in the comments, tell us what you think about it. And if you have any questions, make sure you leave them down below. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.